We recently went to the Upcountry History Museum in Greenville, South Carolina, where they had the White Christmas exhibit. And these are all costumes that were used in the beloved Christmas movie that is such a classic with Bing Crosby. And what you have right here is that classic sisters act, where they come out at the beginning and are singing, "Sisters, sisters." Seeing this costume up close is really just so incredible, because first of all, the intricacy of the costume is such a classic scene. This is just like one of the pivotal scenes, and to see the costume in person is so amazing, especially this fan, which up close is just like really just very simply made. And then also to see how the colors aren't really as vibrant anymore, so it just has you constantly wondering if they've faded over time or if the Technicolor that they used back then made it look something different. Now, right here, this blue does look really, really bright blue like it did on the screen. So maybe it's just each costume fades in their own unique way. But just love looking at all the appliques and the details and imagining making these costumes back then. Okay, so these are the costumes. This is the pivotal moment that everybody wants to see. And these are the costumes that the two sisters were wearing at the end of the movie. This is what they looked like, but this is not the actual costumes. Nobody knows what happened to the original costumes for the ending scene of White Christmas. Some thoughts are that they could have been repurposed into another costume for another movie, or perhaps they're in the home of a private collector and nobody knows about it. But this sleigh ride scene with the bag of presents and the two very ornate red dresses, this is just what everybody wants to see. So I love that this exhibit had it displayed just like this, so you could see all of those little details and recreations of the red dresses. Now, this White Christmas exhibit is only the second time that these costumes and this exhibit has been shown in America. Again, this was in Greenville, South Carolina at the end of 2020 and beginning of 2021. This is done in conjunction with the Rosemary Clooney Estate. Now you're gonna see some other costumes here as well. This is from the dance scenes. I have to admit that these costumes didn't look nearly as, as wow as they do on screen when you saw them in person, but it's like so nice to be able to see them in person and to just kind of think back to what they look like on screen and how it's different and how costume designers probably design things so that they look better on screen. Now this little tulle skirt on this classic costume, it was just really nice to see all of these details. Those green jumpsuits from that dance number, though, did not look nearly as green as they do in the movie. They were kind of really blah and just like polyester looking in person, which again is just something really, really unique to see. And these are some of the sequined gloves. It's interesting that you can see like the sequins are actually chipping and falling off. And it kind of puts in perspective just how old these costumes are. We really liked how there was kind of some displays explaining what the costumes were and in what part of the movie. For those that might not be familiar with the movie that might be going with you just to see the exhibit, these are the military uniforms that are used at the beginning of the movie. The one in the middle is what Bing Crosby wore. And so to see these displayed, it's interesting that all three men were kind of the same size to look at these costumes in comparison with each other and to put it in the backdrop of like a White Christmas scene. So this was really interesting to see the men's costumes. Now, all throughout the exhibit, there was just a lot of promotional materials that you could see, especially promotional materials in other languages, in other countries. It's so unique to see how movies were promoted back then compared to how they're promoted now. Very fascinating. This is Rosemary Clooney's robe from when she went to get her hot milk or buttermilk in the kitchen and started talking with Bing Crosby. Again, it's something that looks so simple in person, but on screen it looks so much more dramatic. And then this is a famous costume from one of those dance scenes with Rosemary Clooney. Very simple, just classic black, but you'll remember that scene. These are costumes from all three ladies in White Christmas. And what is very interesting is that the housekeeper's costume in person was actually the most interesting and looked the best, looked the most expensive and tailored, so to speak. And this is Rosemary Clooney's dress from the engagement party night. And in person, it just looks so simple. It's kind of spotted. So like, you know, obviously it's been used and loved, and it's just so interesting to see. Now, this is actually some paperwork from the costuming department. And again, if you're really into costuming, seeing this stuff is amazing. How they have the fabric samples. They had ideas for stuff that just didn't work. As you can see, it says out. Then you have a Rosemary Clooney's kind of GI outfit. And they have an explanation of how they make the costumes, and those brown ones right there is kind of how they do it in stages. And then you see a lot of information about Edith Head and how she was integral in making a lot of the costumes for some of the big movies back then. This is, again, some of the promotional materials that were used to promote the movie. It is just really, really fascinating to see this stuff in person. Also in this display is a letter that Bing Crosby wrote, and he was talking about the need to get a dynamite person to play against him in that role. And what is fascinating is reading this letter and knowing that after this, they've chose Rosemary Clooney, who is like iconic in White Christmas, and just seeing him put to paper what his thoughts were about casting across from him was really fabulous. And they do have some photo ops with the exhibit. That is one of the classic ones. And then obviously you can be part of the Sisters Act as well. Highly suggest you see the White Christmas exhibit,